the Star Wars fans and collectors, FlyGuy for FlyGuy.net. Back again with a little look at something kind of unusual. Received this in the mail the other day from one of the PR companies that very kindly sends us some Star Wars goodies now and again. Kinder Surprise Twist Heads. A very unusual range of toys which came out in Germany at the beginning of the year 2013. And now finally made their way to Australia here. Don't think they've quite reached to the UK or not. Please let me know if they have, or the UK or Ireland. Definitely not made it to the States. But this rather interesting box came here in this very Darth Vader black. And inside was six Kinder Eggs, with which the chocolate has been devoured. Not by me. I did take these into work and shared these with a friend. But they did kindly donate the toys just so I could have a look at these and give you guys a review. So that's the box itself. There's a little bit of a clone trooper there with a kind of forced perspective photography, and one of the kind of pieces of the PR company that they've sent here is it's really talking about the photography for some reason on these toys. There's no real mention of the toys at all, but it's all about this guy Andrew White who's done the photography. And very good it is too, but I'm more concerned, what the hell are these toys? Very unusual things. I'd seen them actually launch just here in Australia, as I say, in a supermarket and on a poster in a store one evening last week, and the next day this was in the mail for me, so good timing for those guys, because I was wondering, what the hell is going on? So six Kinder Eggs. You basically get a chocolate egg. If you've never seen Kinder, it's dark chocolate and white chocolate. And inside is always this Kinder Surprise, a little egg-shaped component. Open that up and you get all sorts of toys. Now, very famously, many years ago, we got some hippos, blue hippos in Europe, and I think in some parts of the world, these Star Wars hippos that came out from Kinder. But they haven't done anything Star Wars since then, but this is the package that came with them. Inside, just to give you an idea, there is a little flyer in there, and there you can see the range. Let me just zoom in closely for you. This is the range that you can find inside. Obi-Wan, Jar Jar, Darth, Padme R2, Dooku, 3PO, Yoda, Jango, and the Clone Trooper. Now, it doesn't really give you much in the way of instructions. It does say there here that it's almost basically like a scanner, like a QR code. Now, I've tried in vain to scan that code. I'll keep trying to find out what goes on, but I take it, it takes you to the website, toomagic.com, and you unlock some other wallpapers and goodies. On the back of it there, you'll see one that I've got here, Jango. It's basically a gigantic key ring that can go around, your keys or whatever you want to clip them onto. And here's what it does. You open up the twist heads, two of them, twist them around and put the two heads together, kind of like a weird symbiotic child of some kind, which is very bizarre. And there's numbers inside the head itself. And I guess the game is, if you get the highest score, then you won. So you put the two heads together and twist, and then, you know, whoever gets the highest score wins. So that's pretty much it. So let's get a look at the toys themselves. Here's Jango Fett. Now, the heads themselves click around as you turn. Let me focus that a bit more and you'll see that. There we go. So pretty basic printing on the figure you'll see there. The arms look as if they're ready to move, but I can assure you they do not. So they will snap off if you move them. So pretty limited in terms of articulation on them. We get a bit of a hint that obviously it's Jango there with the colours, but that's about it. We do get a printed rocket pack on the back of them. This thread, pretty durable thread through the head. As I say, if you just give that a bit of a tug, it'll pop open his head. And you'll see inside this weird kind of dial, and you can just about make up the... there's a number 5 in that little eyelet. There we go. So if I twist his head, there we go. What does it say now? It would help if I moved out of the way, then you could see. It's a 6. So I guess that's the point. So here's another one here, which is Dooku. And again, a decent kind of incarnation of Dooku with these white heads there. No print on the back on that one. But again, pop open that head there, if I can. Come on. And again, inside is one of those little scores and whatnot. Take the other twist head and you kind of clip them together. This, it's got a weird kind of Siamese twins joined at the head kind of vibe going on there. It's very unusual, but I guess you twist and you twist, and whoever, you know, wants you then part. In this case, who's won there? I can't even determine. It looks like Jang would won with six, so there we go, just about six. So that's the game, or sorry, Dooku won with six. That's the game itself. It's a little unusual. I could show you some of these figures. Certainly there's one other thing in there, just a bit of a flyer about basically don't swallow them, don't put them up your bum, that kind of thing, so don't do that. And as I say, that is the range of them. So all very prequel heavy figures, pretty much, very popular characters. Jar Jar's in there, joy. Darth doesn't look too bad. Django, not seen a clone trooper. And the Yoda looks pretty evil looking, but that's it. So thank you to One Green Bean, thanks to the guys there for sending that along to have a look at it. But the chocolate is yum, I have to say, very nice. And these are all over Australia as we speak, in stores and Coles and all sorts of different supermarkets and retailers. Wherever you buy chocolate, you can pretty much get these guys. So that's it. Very unusual kind of piece, but it's Star Wars related, and thought we'd share that with you. But let us know what you think. Kind of surprise, suck, or great? Tell us. Cool toys or not? They're kind of unusual. Certainly very Japanese orientated in my mind. You don't normally get these things outside of Japan, as far as I can tell. So kind of nice move by Kinder. Very unusual company in that way, but kind of cool. Let us know what you think. Leave a comment below. Like it, hate it. Give a thumbs up, give a thumbs down. We'd love to know what you think. And whether or not you're going to be collecting these or not, we'd love to know. Tell us as well if you've seen these in your country. Again, I think it's pretty much been Europe and Australia that got these. New Zealand, I'm sure, as well. But tell us. Let us know. Tell other people. And if you want to see more Star Wars goodies and other toys, we've got a pile of vintage stuff we've got to bring up, or Black Series as well. So, yeah, you can join us on facebook.com/flyguy.net. We're also on Twitter, twitter.com/flyguy, and on Google Plus as flyguy. That's it. We'll see you for more Star Wars unusual reviews coming up soon. Cheers.